Hi, hello students, welcome to SPV Education World. Together we create a better world. Today we're going to see about money bills and financial bills and what are the difference between them and how they are being introduced in our parliament. Okay, my dear friends, before that, this is the 22nd class in polity. In English, you won't find remaining 21 classes. Don't worry, my dear friends. Actually, I have been taking these classes in Tamil and Telugu. Now I had thought that I'll be making my own notes and I'll be taking class for money bills and financial bills. That will help you to much more precisely, so that I started this from here. Previous classes also I'll be including them to you in our playlist, so kindly subscribe and watch our playlist. You'll get all the classes. And one more important thing is that why I'm not posting that as soon as possible, because is that we don't have that much views in English. So if I get more supports and more requests, then again I'll make all the videos in that. Okay friends, now we shall move on. As usual, we're gonna start our class with a good motivational quote. See here friends, what defines us is how well we rise after we fall. Remember this friends, everybody has failures, everybody will suffer a lot in their life, everybody face the worst situations in life. That doesn't really matter for you in your life, and also nobody cares for your failures. Just the thing is that matters is that how you rise again, and how well you rise again, and how you prove to this world how much powerful you are, how much strength you have, how much will you have, how much capacity you have. That is the thing that will make the difference. You prove to the people that what you can, and that is the one you can show the people, my dear friend. As usual, we start the class with our money bills. Now we shall see here money bills. In previous class, 21st class, we'll be seeing about mostly this ordinary bill. Now here, if you want to know about money bill, just remember the article 110. As usual, whatever the definitions, conditions explained in the article 110, those are followed under money bill. See here, what is money bill? It is defined in article 110. The conditions given in article 110, everything is considered as a money bill. Okay, what are all the conditions given by the Constitution in article 110? We shall see here one by one on few things, and after that also we'll be having a revision here. Imposition, abolition, remission, alteration and regulation of any tax. Here central government, if it is imposing any tax like new tax like GST, and also if it is abolishing any taxes like sales tax and other tax has been, indirect taxes has been abolished and they had introduced GST, and also a remission of any tax, altering any tax, regulating any tax. Okay, whatever the things that is done to the tax is considered as the money bill. So everything must be introduced in the parliament as a money bill. Now in the same thing, if you are borrowing money from union government, those things are regulated through money bill. And next, you know the consolidated fund and contingency fund. If you are not knowing, we'll make a further class of it. Consolidated fund is a fund through which a government expenses, everything are regulated and budgetary expenses. Contingency fund is an emergency fund at any unexpected situations. We use this contingency fund, and it is also maintained by president. And also whatever the things consider here, the both things are custodian or maintained by the parliament. And also here arrows, one is incoming and one is outgoing. So whatever the money that is incoming to the both the funds, and whatever the money that is taken out of these funds, everything is to be introduced in the parliament in the name of money bills. And also here we can see any expenses or appropriations of money out of consolidated fund of India. If you are taking some money from consolidated fund of India for the expenses, so those things are considered as the money bills. And next we can see whatever the expenditures on the consolidated fund. If you want to increase the expenditures, or you must show the expenditures that you have spent. And next you can see receipts of the money regarding the consolidated fund, public accounts, and also public accounts also we maintain the amount. Here we can see it is maintained, custody means it is maintained, and also whatever the issue of such money is provided. And also if you want to add it, we must know what are all the details and expenses spent over in consolidated fund and public accounts. You must, by union or state government, everything must be taken care under money bill. Okay friends, this is all what it takes by the money bill. And next we can see what are all not a money bill. There is a bill introduced regarding financial matters, but that is not a money bill. Which situations? Here if our government is imposing some fines or penalties, those things doesn't come under money bill. And also we are demanding of payment of fees for as a license, and also we are providing any fee for services. So So these things never come under money bill. And also here one more thing, imposition, abolition, remission, alteration, regulation. We have all things regarding tax, but where it is local authority. So if you are considering for a local authority means panchayati, government, gram sabha, these things will be seeing. So the local level, you can see municipalities also, this local level or local authority for local purposes, some bodies introducing a tax or abolishing a tax, remissioning a tax, alteration tax, regulation tax, that doesn't come under money bill, because money bill is regarding the regulation of the taxes at national level and state level. But there is a ground level, is called as gram panchayati level, or considered as local authoritative standard. So those are maintained by themselves. So that is called as ground root governance. We will be seeing in governance topics also, my dear friend. Those are considered as a non-money bills. So we know where is a money bill and what is a non-money bill. So in the exams, they'll be asking local authorities and local purposes tax are introduced. Those things comes under money bill or not? That never comes under money bill. Okay, now you have a clarity. Now we shall see what are all the provisions and important things regarding the money bill. Who introduced the money bill? Where do we introduce? See here, Speaker of Lok Sabha is a sole decision maker. He has a full power and his decision is a final regarding the money bill. Yeah, now the bill is introduced, it must be introduced in Lok Sabha only. So money bill, it must be introduced in Lok Sabha only. When it is introduced, Lok Sabha speaker takes the money bill and says, okay, this is the money bill, it is final, that's all. Nobody, his decision is final and nobody can question. See here, court never can question the speaker, and also parliament can never questions, and also president also can never questions how he had made this bill as a money bill. So his decision is a final decision. Now we know that this bill can only introduced in a Lok Sabha, but it also must be introduced with recommendation of president. Yeah, if you want to introduce a money bill, it must be recommended by a president that it must be introduced in Lok Sabha. And money bill is considered as a government bill. As you know that in previous class, we can see what is public bill and what is private bill. And now money bill is always a government bill. Why it is always a government bill? It is always a government bill because only the minister can introduce this bill. Yeah, here, who can introduce the money bill? Only minister. Remember this, only minister. So it is considered as a government bill because whatever the tax or consolidated fund, these things are related to the money that are required for the government. So obviously, it is introduced by minister. And also, when the bill is passed in Lok Sabha, it moves on to the Rajya Sabha. Yeah, Rajya Sabha. In Rajya Sabha, money bill doesn't have any much power, my dear friend. It has a restrictive power regarding money bill. Who has less power? Rajya Sabha has very less power. How? We can see here, Rajya Sabha can never reject or amend the money bill. That is more important topic you must remember. It can never reject or amend the money bill, Rajya Sabha, but it can make recommendations. Sir, these changes must be made. It can suggest like that. But that suggestions, it is discretionary for Lok Sabha. Either they can accept or reject those recommendations. So it is up to them. They can say yes or no. And next, Rajya Sabha does not return the bill. Okay, here, if Rajya Sabha does not return the bill, how many days it can hold the bill? In ordinary bill conditions, it can hold up to 6 months, my dear friend. But in money bill, it doesn't have that much power. It can hold only up to 14 days. If it holds more than 14 days, the bill is considered to be passed. There is no any deadlock situations. It is directly deemed to be passed. So it is passed in both houses. Again, it goes to the president approval. Regarding the president approval also, money bill has a restrictive power to president also. Here, what are all these things? He can either approve or withhold, but he can never return or reject the bill. Remember this, president can never return or reject the money bill when it comes after passing through the both the houses. Why? Here already you had seen this, the bill is introduced by recommendation of president. If president recommends and introduces the bill, how he can reject or return the bill? That is a condition it is given. So he cannot reject the bill. And next you can see here, money bill, always regarding money bill, Lok Sabha has more power than Rajya Sabha. In ordinary bill, Lok Sabha is equal to Rajya Sabha. We had already seen what are all the power regarding Rajya Sabha. When we are seeing, we had seen all the less powers that it had. And next we can see about a differences between ordinary bill and money bill. We know what is ordinary bill and also we know what is money bill. Now we shall compare them. Okay, now we can see here where the ordinary bill can be introduced. If you want to introduce an ordinary bill, it must be introduced in any house. Either it can be introduced in Lok Sabha or it can be introduced in Rajya Sabha. So because actually we have seen that Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha has equal power regarding ordinary bill. So any house we can introduce. But in money bill, there is higher power for a Lok Sabha. So this bill can only be introduced in a Lok Sabha. And here ordinary bill can be introduced either by minister or private. So it can be a private bill or a government bill. But here if you consider for money bill, it is only introduced by minister. So it is obviously the government bill or public bill. Yeah. Now we can see here it is introduced. But is there any recommendation of president required for the money bill in ordinary bill? Sorry, for ordinary bill, no, there is no any recommendation required for introducing the ordinary bill, but the introduction of a money bill, it is compulsory for the recommendation of president is required. And next, Rajya Sabha can amend or reject the ordinary bill, but Rajya Sabha can never amend or reject the ordinary bill. Also, the Rajya Sabha can hold the ordinary bill for maximum period of 6 months. More than that, it cannot hold. But if you see here, in a money bill, Rajya Sabha has a maximum power of 14 days to hold the bill. And also, is there any certification of the ordinary bill by the Speaker of Lok Sabha? No, there is no any certification. And also, it is passed, when it is passed in Lok Sabha, it directly goes on to the Rajya Sabha. But here, in a money bill, it must be certified by the Lok Sabha Speaker. And also, it must be after passing in the Lok Sabha, the Speaker must send it to the Rajya Sabha. Next, we can see here, there is a deadlock in an ordinary bill. Yeah, what is the deadlock? Everything will be seeing during the joint sitting, so no issues. If it arises due to deadlock, the president has a power to call for or summon for a joint sitting. But regarding money bill, there is no deadlock and also there is no joint sitting, because if it is maintained more than 14 days, which means hold in Rajya Sabha for 14 days, obviously it is considered as passed. So the where is the condition for deadlock? So there is no condition for deadlock, and also there is no condition for joint sitting also. And next we can see, it must be, if it is, yeah, ordinary bill, if it is introduced by the minister in Lok Sabha and if it is defeated, see here, if it is a government bill and ordinary bill is a government bill and introduced in Lok Sabha, and if it is defeated, there is a chance that government must resign. But it is not a condition for private bill or other conditions. But in a money bill, if you consider, if it must be introduced in Lok Sabha. So if the money bill is defeated, so obviously government must resign, because it is a government's expenditure bill. So obviously government must prove it sign. And next we can see here, president, so what are the powers of president in ordinary bill? He can reject, he can approve, he can withhold, or he can return. But here he can give either his assent or either he can withhold. He cannot return or reject. Why he cannot return? Because it is already introduced with the recommendation of president, we had seen in the third point. Okay friends, you had understood ordinary bill and money bill differences, so it had much more clarity. Now we can see about financial bills. Financial bills, you must be extra careful because it has more things to study and remember. See here, financial bills means whatever the fiscal matters, economic matters like revenue and expenditure, whatever the consideration regarding the revenue and expenditure is taken, those things are considered as a financial bills. Now let us see here, financial bills are of three kinds. What are all the types of financial bills? One thing is money bill, we had already seen. Other thing is financial bill of type 1, and also one other thing is financial bill of type 2. And here article 110 is clearly given about money bill, and also financial bill of type 1 is explained in article 117 class 1, and also here financial bill of type 2 is explained in article 117 class 3. Here you know money bill, already we had seen that. One thing we must be remembering here, my friends, I have provided an image. This image speaks you a lot. See here, this is a money bill, this is a financial bill. So all money bills are compulsorily financial bill, but not all financial bill can be considered as the money bill. Something like syllogism we used to study in a reasoning concept. Okay friends, and next we can see here financial bill of class type 1. Yeah, this is the thing you must be extra careful while learning, because you will be getting confused. Financial bill of class 1 means it contains not only article 110. If it contains only article 110 concepts, it is called as money bill. But if it is having Article 110 plus other general legislation. See here, financial bill of type 1 is when it has not only Article 110 but also plus general legislation. General legislation means other than financial matters, whatever consider, it is considered as a general legislation. And also it doesn't consider only a taxation clause only, it has so it is not solely considering the taxation clause, it has other considerations also, so that it is considered as financial bill 1. Now we shall compare the similarities between a money bill and plus financial bill of type 1. Here both introduced in Lok Sabha. Here it is a much more important, my dear friend. Financial bill of class 1 plus money bill, both the things are compulsorily introduced in Lok Sabha. So obviously in both the situations, Lok Sabha has a higher say than Rajya Sabha. And next thing is, it must be introduced with the recommendation of president. Here also president recommendation is required for financial bill type 1 and money bill. Here you must be extra careful, my dear friends. Next here, what else? Other procedures. Other procedures are as similar as ordinary bill. It goes through all the three readings in first house and second house. And Rajya Sabha, here it has a power than money bill, like it can reject or it can amend. And also non-financial matters only it can amend or reject. Here you had seen that financial type 1 means it has Article 110 matters and also other than financial matters like general legislation. So obviously the Rajya Sabha can reject or amend, not the financial matters. It can reject only non-financial matters that are present in Rajya Sabha. And if the deadlock arises, you know the deadlock situations, if it is not passed for 4 or 6 months or it is rejected in Rajya Sabha, those conditions we consider as a deadlock. And next we can see here, president has a power to call for joint sitting, where in money bill there is no joint sitting clause, but in financial bill 1 and 2 there is a joint sitting clause. Why I am saying repeatedly is, it is as simple as that, just a simple topic, but most of the questions will be for you in a confusing manner, and also you will be making much more mistakes. Under Article 108, he can call for joint sitting, but here president has, either he must give his assent or withhold. He can also return the bill, one thing you remember, but money bill our president cannot return, but financial bill he can return. That is the conditions it is provided. Okay friends, now we can see a financial bill of type 2. You had understood what is the financial bill of type 1 and money bill, it has more similarities, but here financial bill of type 2 is different. Here other than Article 102, other than Article 110, sorry, other than Article 110, whatever the financial matters are considered, is it is considered taken under financial bill of type 2, either financial or expenditure under consolidated fund, whatever the things it is considering as financial things, but it is not taken under the consideration of Article 110. See here, apart from Article 110 matters, it is considered as financial bill of type 2. This is the one thing you must remember. And also it can be introduced in any house. You know that this financial bill of type 2 can be introduced in any house, no worries regarding that. And also it is similar to the ordinary bill. You know the ordinary bill, the same procedure goes on, only one difference regarding president recommendations. If you are considering financial bill of class 1, sorry, type 1 or money bill, both the bills need a president recommendation before introduction, which means before introducing the bill. While introducing the bill, it needs introduction. But here in financial bill of type 2, need not require president recommendation for introduction of the bill. So if you are introducing the bill, there is no need of president recommendations. And also it needed to be passed in each house. Yeah, president recommendation is needed for passed in each house. Here is a Rajya Sabha and here is a Lok Sabha. In each house separately, there is a need of a president recommendation that is being given here. And also now we can see here, it can be rejected in any house. As usual, if it is similar to the ordinary bill, so it can be rejected in any house. If a deadlock situation arises, president has the power to create a joint sitting or summon a joint sitting. Also regarding a president powers, if it is passed in both the houses or joint sitting, it goes to the president. There he can give his assent or withhold his assent. Also he can return it for reconsideration. You have been clear, much more clear, my dear friend. There is no confusion in this financial bill clause type 2. Everything is similar to that. But thing is that apart from 110, whatever the economic matters or financial matters, it is under financial bill clause 2. And other things it is similar to ordinary bill, only the difference is president recommendation at house level. but not in an introduction stage. Okay, friends, you would have been much more clear. Once again, if you revise, it will be much more clear, my dear friends. Okay, friends, thank you. Thanks for watching SPV Education World. Together we create a better world. If you're not yet subscribed, subscribe to our channel. And also kindly watch our playlist so that you don't get confused, because Tamil, Telugu, Hindi, English, four languages I'm taking classes. And also only for some working on all the videos that I'm providing. So kindly keep supporting. And also those who are already subscribed and supporting, thanks to you, friends. Other classes in English, I'll make more videos. But thing is that I don't, if I get more requests, I can make videos. As usual, our views are much more less, and also it is a multilingual channel. It cannot be promoted in YouTube, so that is why we get less views. But still, we don't work for views, we work for students. So thing is that you must be the person one who spreads to the other people so that they can get benefit and they can view all the topics that are required for the exam and prepare for the exams, my dear friends. Thank you. This is me, SP Rajan, taking classes for you. Those who are supporting me, I thank everyone. Okay, friends, bye, take care.